Hi everybody, let me know if you can see me in the chat. We just went live, so if everything worked well, you can see me right now in the chat. Please type in the chat if you can see me, so I check that you guys are seeing me. So I am seeing quite some people that have been attending. I see Tim, Jills, Ahab, Josue, not sure if I pronounced that correctly. I'm sure. I see a lot of anonymous people. You can share your name and where you're from in the chat. And I see Mima, Doka, Christopher, Nice, Babs is there. I see many known names that have been joining other live events before. So it's good to see you guys again. Some of you, I haven't seen you in a while. So it's nice to kind of connect over chat and speaking again. So there's Monica from the Netherlands. So yeah, it's so awesome to see all of you. For those who aren't aware yet, today we are celebrating the opening, the registration opening of the Adult Violin Camp that takes place in the Netherlands. And I'm going to reveal all the details and all the secrets about like where it takes place. And I will share a fancy video with you guys from the location. And yeah, first, I will share a little bit more about the camp, and after that, we will take about, I think, 30 minutes at most or something like that to answer all your questions. And after that, you can register for the camp, and the registration officially opens. So yeah, I'm super excited for this to happen. And I'm also so thankful for everybody that showed up. It's so nice to see you guys. And yeah, let's get started. So before, I would like you to answer something in the comments, and I see you guys are, meanwhile, just click the chat button to the right of the video and you can answer in the comment. I see that Mima, quite some of you have been figuring it out. Marianne here. And yeah, so please write in the comment if you've ever participated in a live violin event before, if you've ever participated in a camp before or played in a group of violin players, and what your experience was. So please let me know, have you ever visited a violin camp before and what was it like? Or maybe you could just type one word to describe your experience if you're not so fond of typing a lot of words. So yeah, let me know one word to describe your experience. I see Anya has arrived, Sherry. Sherry says, never visited a camp. Tim says, no camp or group experience. So quite some of you are really new to the idea of a violin camp, which is awesome. And that makes so much sense because, yeah, some of us are just in the beginning phases of playing the violin. And there are not that many camps for people in the beginning phases that are actually adults. And that is actually also one of the reasons that we organized this camp, because I feel like it is so much fun to play together, and it's so like, it's, I think, one of the most fun experiences that I had when playing the violin was participating in camps. And there's a lot of camps for children, a lot of camps for professional players or people that are really good already, like playing in orchestras and so on, but not that many camps for people in the middle that are adult and just started the violin. So that is one of the most important reasons we are actually organizing this, because I really want you to experience this one time too. And now I see some people saying, I joined Vibrato first summer camp. Yes, you've been joining the online camp. Who are you? I might still remember. I'm quite sure I will remember. Yeah, and Jill says, first time to join a camp. Monica for Barcelona is living in the Netherlands right now. That's so awesome, and you live so close to the camp location. I joined lots of camps as a kid, so excited to have one as an adult. So yeah, some of you have been seeing camps, some of you have not. Maybe I can share a little bit about my experiences with camps before I share the video of our camp. So what also really inspires me to organize this, because honestly, if there's one thing that I think is so nice about playing music, and like maybe even I would say the best thing I have ever experienced through music, and my life is revolved around music, right? I'm a teacher, I'm teaching music, I'm working with students, like everything in my life revolves around music. And still, I think one of the best experiences I had when playing music is playing together with other people. And camps is definitely like, yeah, I would even say the number one experience I had. I think I've played in orchestras before and in bands, but yeah, I think camps were one of the best things I have done. So I think the most fun thing about camps is that you can just connect with others and you really quickly make friends because everybody is having the same shared passion. And you really get into this kind of other world where everybody is super passionate about violin playing and everybody wants each other to improve. And it's like really like a parallel universe where you're getting into. And I feel like that's the awesome thing about camp. You feel like, oh yes, of course, everybody's playing music and playing music every day together. So yeah, that's exactly why I love it so much that we are doing this, because yeah, I love camps. I love participating. And it has been a lifelong dream of mine to organize a camp myself too, because because honestly, I think it is one of the best things you can do as a violinist to participate in a camp. So I'm really, really happy to share this with you. So yeah, I see some people say I'm coming all the way from Wisconsin, and oh my God, I would be so honored to welcome people from all the way across the world. That would be, wow, amazing. So okay, now we are going to share about our camp, because I know that is what everybody has been waiting for. Probably I'm talking too long already because I'm getting too excited about camps and how awesome they are and so on. So right now we are going to watch a video together. I should put on the sound. So yeah, so I'm going to share our final location, and in the video you can also see the date of our camp, where we are going to hold the event, and afterwards I'm going to share more about the schedule, exactly everything that we will be doing during our camp and after our camp. And yeah, okay, let's get started. So yeah, I'm going to figure out how to show you guys the video. So I'm not sure if Ineke is in the chat. Can we say Ineke? Is Ineke in the chat right now? I'm not sure. But I have been asking you guys to ask, I've been asking you guys to guess where you think the camp is going to be. And Ineke guessed the right location. That was amazing. She knew like exactly the exact address of the place. So I'm not sure how she did it, but in some way she made this happen. Right now, you guys should be able to see my screen, and it should look really, really weird right now. That's normal. Okay, we are going to share more about location. This is going to be a 5-day camp in this awesome location, and we are going to do so many fun activities that I will share right after the video. Thank you. Okay, guys, so this is the video, and here you can also directly see the final date of our camp, July 29th until August 2, 2019 in the Netherlands. The camp is going to take place. I'm going to make sure that I'm not screen sharing anymore. Let me know what you think about it in the comments. I would love to see. Oh my God, I'm seeing some people, right? Oh, Big Mama Violin. Who is that? I believe I know you, but I'm not sure who you are right now. Whoa, that looks great. You've been participating in Vibrato Camp, right? So Georgia Lady says, hi, she's just dropping in. So many people say, wow, it's a beautiful location. And yes, and Ineke says, I'm fairly good with Google. Ineke, this is like extreme. Your Google talent, I'm not sure how you did it, but Ineke was the one that just guessed the exact spot of our camp. So I'm not sure. Yeah, so I'm going to share a little bit more about the camp right now. So first of all, make sure to check the dates in your calendar, 29th of July until the 2nd of August. So it's going to be a 5-day camp. And after that, we have 2 days of post-camp activity. So it will be 1 week experience. And yeah, and this week we are going to do many really cool things. And maybe the easiest way to share a little bit more about that is by sharing the schedule with you. So I will put on my screen share again. So to share exactly what we will be doing during the camp. Okay, here's going to be the schedule of our camp. So I hope everybody can see the schedule right now. If not, please write it in the chat. So this is going to be exactly what we will be doing in our days in the Netherlands. So it will take place in Limburg. Limburg is, I think, it is the most beautiful part of the Netherlands. It is not at all well known because all tourists are going to like the bigger cities and so on, which are in the west. But actually, many of the Dutch people tell that this is like one of the most beautiful parts of the Netherlands because it is the most green. There's a lot of nature and it is a very, very nice place, I think, to host a camp. It's one of my favorite parts. So here you can see our camp schedule. Of course, some things will be voted by the final participants. So it is going to be a small group. There will be at most, absolute most, 14 people. And so it will be really personal. And we will also be just talking on the dinner table and see if everybody likes to do the things that we are doing. And yeah, so it may be personalized if the group really decides they want to do something else. But I think this is going to be the general schedule. So on the first day, of course, we start our camp. We are all setting up. We are getting ready in our rooms and kind of get to feel comfortable. This is also the day where everybody will get picked up at the train station or at the airport. If you will be coming by plane, you will get picked up at the airport if you want to. And yeah, we kind of make sure that everybody is arriving comfortably. And then we are also directly getting started on day one with our opening circle and violin warm-ups, because probably you have been traveling to our place and you haven't been playing violin yet. So we will directly start warming up in the group and, of course, getting to know each other, sharing our names with each other. And yeah, we will directly start playing. And meanwhile, our cook will already be cooking a delicious dinner for us. So we will have dinner after that, and after dinner we will have workshops. Now I'm not going to say everything exactly because you can write it on the see it on the site as well, but I think most importantly there's two main things that we will be doing with at the camp, maybe three, because one part is of course sightseeing, but violin is going to be like 90% of everything that we will do, or 95%. It will be the big part of our camp. So on the one hand, we are going to play together. This is going to be a huge part of the camp. And I think that is so important because playing together, that is in the end, right? That is the most important thing about doing a camp. It is so much fun to play together, to learn to play together, because many of you are beginners and have never really experienced or not very often to play with other people. And that is something you can learn. And we will learn that together. So we will do ensemble classes where we will vote for pieces that we will learn together. And we will do all kinds of other things to learn how to play together, like workshops where we will be working on specific parts of our playing. We will be voting in the group for pieces that we are going to practice together, and we will form a little mini orchestra with different levels. So that goes all the way from absolute beginner level to the part where you kind of learned third position and in higher positions, and a little bit the more advanced players will be playing the high part, the beginner players will be playing, you know, the open strings, and then there's also a part in between where you will, like, mostly will be in first position. And if that doesn't really say anything to you, there's like going to be different levels provided at the camp. And I think most people that will be joining, or that this camp would be most perfect for, is those that feel like they are at a beginner to intermediate level on the violin. This is not for the advanced players. There's enough camps for that already. So this is going to be the people that can play Hallelujah on the violin, or maybe even recently started learning, maybe for half a year or something like that, or a few months, and you can learn a few songs on the violin, but you feel like you cannot participate in an orchestra yet. On the other hand, the higher parts, the best people could also participate in an orchestra, but you would be a second violinist in a community orchestra. That would be kind of your level. So that is the level of our workshops and our ensemble classes. And then another really important part of one important thing, we will also be jamming, and I will be teaching you how to, because I know nobody ever wants to jam without any sheet music, but I will teach you in a workshop how to do it. And it's not as scary as you think it will be, but so it's going to be a lot of fun, and we are going to encourage each other, even if it sounds like shit, so don't worry. Other hand, we are also going to have another part of the camp, and that is our private sessions. Everybody in the camp will be preparing one personal piece that he or she will perform at the recital at the end of the camp. So at the end of the camp, we will have a common recital, and everybody will be preparing something to play there. And this is going to be your kind of personal challenge. You pick a piece exactly as your level, and you will get coached throughout the camp to perform this piece as good as you can. And you won't only be coached by me, but also by our piano player and conductor, Ineke. Ineke is my mother, and she also volunteered to participate in the camp. And she is a music teacher that has more than 30 years of experience. She has been teaching me a lot of what I know. So actually, I wouldn't play the way I played without her. And she also accompanies people professionally. So she will give you a chance, and me together, because of course I can't teach everybody at the same time. So we will be dividing everybody, and some people will be having class with her, some with me, and then all the time it changes around. So some days you will be with her, some days you will be with me. And you will get prepared to play this personal piece at the recital. You will be playing together with your accompanist, so which will be Ineke. I will link you in a moment to the page where you can read more about that too. So, but that is going to be a fun thing to do. Many of you maybe have never done like a serious concert preparation, and it is something else. It's not just about learning to play the notes or playing it right, but also about preparing for a concert. How do you go about it? How do you go about playing with a piano player? Or how do you go about communicating with your accompanist? Because if you are at a higher level of playing, you are mostly playing in duos, or you're playing in orchestras, and you need to learn this too. So yeah, we are going to have both of it. We are going to play together, and we are going to play in a smaller duo formation where everybody gets a chance to really challenge themselves to get to a higher level. And I included this in the camp too, because I think it can be a lot of fun to feel like you're exactly getting challenged at your level. And that is what can happen in private lessons, where you can really focus on the things that will make you move forward and become a better player. And I have done camps in the past too. I have both been attending a lot of private lessons during camp and done camps that only had workshops, and I really, really liked the camps. Like, the best experiences I had with the camps where we were also preparing something for ourselves. I won't ever forget this experience of really going for preparing a piece with several teachers. It is a very exciting experience. So I wanted to include it. And I also think it is so much fun to, in the end, be able to show your new friends what you have been working on. Because by that time, I know so many of you probably are like, oh my God, I never want to perform in recital. But by that time, you will have played with these people for several days. And normally musicians get friends very quickly because we all have the same passion for playing. And I'm quite sure that by the end of our camp, everybody will encourage you so much that you want to play at a recital. But it's optional. So you can still opt out. Now I'm going to check the chat if there's any questions so far, because I would love to hear what would you like me to tell more about in the camp. I would really, really like to answer all your questions. And I'm also going to share the page soon about the registration page. But first I'm going to check if there's any other questions. So there's some people that say, exactly, I never want to play in a recital. So yeah, you can decide not to play in a recital, and then you will just have the private lessons. Of course, it's going to be so much fun. You will have the private lessons. We will still coach you to play the piece of your choice to the best of your ability. You will get my personal help with choosing a piece that fits your level perfectly before the camp, and you will get a lot of different pieces that you can choose from after your booking. So then I'm helping you to kind of figure out which piece would be the right piece for you, and you can just work on that piece without performing it. I just want to prepare you that probably if you are really attending in the camp, you will have a lot of new friends that will tell you you need to perform. So they will all be like, sure you don't want to perform? So sure. Because I was that one that doesn't want to perform. So I know what it is like to be around new friends, new violin friends. So yeah, I love the love of violin, your ears, I says Mary. So let's see if there's any questions about the camp itself. Okay, the sheet music. The sheet music, you will get sheet music after applying. You will get, like, after booking the camp, you will get sheet music for personal pieces. You get a lot of suggestions. I think there's like over 100 pieces that I've been looking at that you could possibly play at your personal as your personal piece, and you can of course also choose between all pieces you've ever played yourself or come across on the internet, as long as there is a good piano part. Or if you want to play a more like folky piece, you can also get accompanied by me on the guitar. So yeah, let's see. There is some other questions about the price. Yeah, of course, the price is so important. I always forget about all these very practical things. The price is going to be, it depends on what kind of room you choose. And I'm really happy to share that we could keep it very affordable because we've got help from volunteers to make sure that we are going to set this all up, because luckily I have very nice friends in the Netherlands that are helping me out. And yeah, the lowest price to join is 590 euro. That is all inclusive. So you will get bed, you will get food every day, three times a day, healthy meals prepared by a cook. So really good food, not like bad camp foods that you would get in some of these kind of experiences. We are going to give you healthy and nice vegetarian food, because I'm a vegetarian, so, and some of the people that are joining too. So I guess that is easiest because I have no experience preparing other kinds of food, and the cook doesn't have either. So that is why we decided for that, and it's very healthy too. Of course, everybody that really misses meat for a few days, you can always decide to prepare something yourselves, because we have two kitchens, I believe. So yeah, so you can always cook something next to it for yourself. But yeah, it's going to be really delicious food 3 times a day. Yeah, and that would be a 4-bedroom. So that is the cheapest option you can have. You have a 4-bedroom. By the way, if you already have friends that maybe you know want to participate too, mainly directing at the people that are in Julia's Violin Academy, because I know many of you are interested in joining. And if you want to be in a room with specific people, you can tell me and I will try to place you as much as possible in the rooms with people you want to get placed with. So yeah, you have a 4-person room, you have a 2-person room and a 1-person room. Yeah, oh, there's also somebody that is asking, it's $670. That is an important thing to mention. So yeah, I think that is a really good price, like especially if you compare it with all camps I've been on. I've never been able to go to such an affordable camp. And we do this because we really, really want to make this happen. For us, most important is that we break even, because it's our first time organizing this. We know this is, we need trust, you know, because we have never done this before, but we know it is going to be really, really awesome. And it will really be worth it. So yeah, because often on camps you won't get included food and accommodation. You will have to pay this price and then you don't even have your accommodation or food. So yeah. The airport. Somebody asked in which airport. There's an airport around 30 minutes where we can pick you up. It is called Weser. It's a German airport, Weser. It's in the close to Düsseldorf, and you can get all the information on the camp page. Also, after you registered, you get a full welcome pack where I share everything with you, like exactly where, what to do before joining the camp, like making sure you are insured in the right way and you're getting your visas. Because if you're from the US or like other countries than Europe, European countries, you maybe need a visa. USA people and Canada people can actually come for 90 days without a visa. Or like they get a visa upon arrival. That is what I know from other American people that have been visiting the Netherlands. Except if you were in Europe for a long time already this year, that would be different. Do you fly into Germany? Yeah, if you want to fly into the airport that is directly next to the camp location, that is maybe not always the affordable option. Sometimes it's better to fly to an airport somewhere else in the country and then stay a night somewhere there, you know. But the airport close to our camp location is Weser Airport in Germany. And Sasha is right now sharing it in the chat, so you can have a look at that. And yeah, so we recommend to have a look at flights with Kiwi. That includes also Weser. Weser is a small airport, but it's like a kind of budget line airport. So close to Düsseldorf. So it's there's a lot of budget flights in Europe going to that airport. So yeah, there's also, if you have any specific allergies or something like that, we can also accommodate that. That is a part of our plan. So you can just apply which kind of allergies you have, and we will already make a schedule of what we will cook a few months before our camp date. So it would be nice if you could apply as soon as possible with all your allergies, so we take everything into account. Everything, like all information, will also be at the camp page that maybe I can share with you guys right now. So that would also mean if I share the page that this is the official opening right now. Now you can start applying. So yeah, let's do it. Okay, so somebody asked for a scholarship. I have actually been thinking about kind of finding patrons or something like that. But right now, this violin camp is like, I know for Tunisia, this is very expensive maybe, but for Dutch proportions, like in the Netherlands, this is very, very cheap, this camp. So it's, yeah, unfortunately, there cannot be any discounts on this. But, oh, maybe there will be a volunteer opportunity. So if you really feel like, oh my God, I really, really want to join and I really don't have the money, there's two options. One is that you can pay in 3 installments. So we actually accept it if you want to pay 3 times $180 or some 180 euros and accept the whole price in full. Or you can send me an email and ask, can I maybe get a discount by volunteering or something like that? And then you can help with some of the organization and the cooking and making sure everything is really comfortable for the guests that arrive. And yeah, so that is a possibility if you have trouble with that. Yeah, the date of our camp is 29. Okay, I'm now sharing the camp. It is called violinvilla.com, violinvilla.com. So that is where you can register right now. So first, kind of first come, first serve, because it might be full because there's at absolute most 14 places that we can give away, because in the end, we want to make this personal experience for everybody of you. And we want to give every student a lot of attention. So that's why we decided to not have more students than that. So yeah, if you want to join, make sure to apply as soon as possible. Not only to ensure the cheapest price, because in this week the prices will be most cheap because you guys will be the founding members of the camp and you will make it possible that I make the deposit for our location. So, but also because I'm not sure how many people will apply. This is the first time, so I can't really make an estimation. But there is a limited amount of places. And that is the only thing. I just don't want it to miss out if you really want to feel like you join. And Karen says, can I get a prize without accommodation? I'm just 1 hour away. Wow, that's amazing. Yeah, good thought. I haven't thought about it, but maybe that's possible. So then it would only be the food and the lessons. So, but yeah, I have to think about it because of course we need the place also for our workshops and so on. So you will still pay a part of the rent of the place because we also need the place to hold the workshop. It will not only be the place to sleep, but also the place for the workshop. But I can make a special price for that. Just let me know. But I think you will have the best experience when joining everything in the camp, because it is going to be fun. Like at night, probably we will have some jam sessions or we do some fun things. So, and the lessons start early in the morning again. So yeah, I think I would prefer to have everybody on the space. I think that is going to be the most cozy experience for everybody. And then rooms will be mixed. So, and what about the optional weekend? So first about the rooms. Okay, so I'm going to try to place everybody in a room with people of their own gender. So if you are a woman, I try to place you with a woman. But of course, I cannot always ensure it, especially in 4 people rooms. I'm not sure how many men and how many women will apply and how it will work out in the end. So yeah, so I cannot assure it, but I will really take it into account as much as possible. So if you really want to be absolutely sure, you need to book a room together with somebody that you know, for instance, a 2-person room, and say, I want to be with this person in a room. And then you can book together. And then I can assure you that you will be only with people in your gender. Or if you find 4 people, that would be great too. Now, the next question was, what about the optional weekend? So the optional weekend will take place if enough people show interest in joining the optional weekend. The optional weekend is right after the camp ended. It will be on Saturday and Sunday, and we will visit Amsterdam and Utrecht, or maybe we will visit Den Haag instead, because Den Haag is close to the sea and many people also like to see the sea, and it is the place where the government is in the Netherlands, so also a great place. So directly after applying, I will put everybody in a group that will join the camp, and then I will ask everybody, like, what will we do after the camp? And if enough people are interested, we will do excursions. And it seems like quite some people are interested to do excursions after the camp in the Netherlands, because quite some of you are coming from further away and would also like to see the Netherlands. And it will also be a fun thing to do with your newfound friends at the camp. So yeah. And somebody says, sorry, the date's not working for me. Oh, that's such a shame. Yeah, it would be nice to see it. Where can you apply? That is violinvilla.com. Violinvilla.com. Marlene says, Julia, can you give me the site where I can set me on the list for the bootcamp? So yeah, violinvilla.com is the place where you can register for the camp. Yeah. Yeah, and oh, so nice. Anja's, Marianne said she just signed up and is sharing a room with Anja. So yeah, I really look forward to meet you in real life, guys. It's very nice. That's amazing. So yeah, does anybody have any other questions? Because I would love to share more or answer all questions about the camp now I'm here. Yeah, so just ask in the chat whatever questions you may have about the camp, and I will answer them to the best of my abilities. I can have a look and give a shout out to anybody that has applied already. So yeah, if you by the way, for those that like Kalin, maybe you do need to apply to. In order to, because then after that I can share about whatever, but you know, about the special prize for if you won't sleep here. But I think it won't be possible, because right now we have a limited amount of participants, 14 people, and I calculated it right now, so that if we have a certain amount of people, our cost will break even. And it is important that, like, if anybody is getting a special prize, then the others actually have to pay more. So probably you could go with the cheapest option of participating the early bird prize, and then you can choose if you want to sleep in the 4-person's room or sleep at home. Yeah, if that would be okay for you, I imagine it would be nicer if you could just could do it differently, but right now I don't know if that's possible. I think for that the prices of the camp are not high enough right now. So does anybody have any questions? I'm not sure about sharing rooms, but I guess it will be all nice people. Julia, can you make also violin tabs? I think that's easier instead of the tutorial. Yeah, I also create violin tabs for all music, but right now I'm trying to make the website more legal, and I cannot share violin tabs of songs that are copyrighted, which is almost every popular song. So I'm creating all the violin tabs and sharing them on musicnotes.com that are legalizing all the sheet music, and but it costs a few euros to purchase the tabs of the videos. If you're interested in that, you can look in the video link descriptions, and I will post them there very soon. Ineke says, why am I anonymous? I have no idea. But I'm going to have a look at the people that have applied to the camp and give them a shout out. So yeah. So let me know if you have any questions. I would love to help you right now with your questions. Yeah, so there, I see that right now there's already 5 people that applied. That is so nice. I'm so excited to see the names, who it is. So I already know that it is Marlene. And so guys, like, really, if you want to join, really be sure to apply in time, because I really don't want anybody. You guys are probably like one of the most excited people, because otherwise you wouldn't be here tonight. So really be sure to be in time, because after this video, I will share the camp everywhere to make sure it will happen, because I want to make sure that everybody who applies really gets the camp and not an email like, oh my God, it's not going to happen, guys. Like, yeah, so I will market it everywhere after this video. So be sure to apply as soon as possible if you want to join, so that you will get one of the spots. Right now, there's 5 people that have applied in the last 10 minutes. And I'm going to check to give everybody a shout out in this video. Okay. So, oh, right now there's 9 people that applied. Okay, so there's 5 places left right now at the camp. If you want to join, be sure to apply now. Oh my God, I'm so excited for this to happen. I really, really look forward to meet everybody in real life, because I've been teaching a lot of online lessons in the past year and I love offline lessons. So I really, really look forward to meet everybody. I'm not sure how to see who applied. This is how professional I am with websites, guys, and the backend. Okay, I'm still trying to figure out. What deposit do you need? So you will either have to pay in 3 installments. So it will be the price of whatever room you choose. And then it will be divided by 3. Or it will be the full price at once. You can choose. Now I finally think I figured out who has applied so far. So right now, 9 people. 9. Oh my God, talking in German. Okay, so the first person that applied was Marianne. Wow, Marianne, you were the first one. That's amazing. Together with Anya, you will definitely be in. And the people that applied first, like, I will also give the rooms to the people that, like, if you, maybe there won't be a room available of your choice anymore, and then I will ask you if you want to apply for another room. And also, next to that, Robin has been applying. Some of you guys might already know her from the Julia's Violin Academy group. That's amazing. Tito has been applying. He is not as active in the violin group, but he is one of my students in Berlin, and he is also in Julia's Violin Academy. And Christopher has applied all the way from USA. That's amazing. That's so amazing. I really, really love this. And Robin is also coming all the way from USA. That is what I'm just seeing. And now trying to see the other people that have applied so far. Yoo-hoo, we are itching to get to the camp. Me too. Like, right now I just want it to happen tomorrow. But I know I still have to do a lot of preparation. So maybe I shouldn't want that. That would probably be a bad idea. But now I'm just so excited. So officially, the camp will happen for sure with so many people applying. So after that, Monica has applied. Monica is this Spanish Monica that lives in the Netherlands, I assume. So thank you so much for applying. It's amazing that you will be there. And we have already done lessons together in vibrato camp. So that's nice. Monica has been one of my first online students, I believe. Oh, my computer is a little bit slow. So the people that have applied are appearing a bit slowly on my screen. Oh, and I will go to the next person very, very soon. So right now, I also love how people from all ages apply, because I know many of the people that have applied have taken one class online before. And yeah, there's now one new response coming in. So now there's 10 people that applied to the camp. So, okay, the next person that applied was Tim. Tim, I'm not sure where you are from. Please share with us in the chat. And I'm so excited that you applied to join the camp. The person after that is Martine. Wow, Martine. We know each other from Vibrato Camp. All the way from Canada, right? That's amazing. I really look forward to meet you. And after that, Marlene. Marlene and Ineke applied after that. So, wow, that's amazing. I'm happy that you can make it, Marlene. Because you were doubting about it. And Ineke, so nice to meet you. And Tim is also coming all the way from Canada, just like Martina. Wow, I really, really think this is going to be a great group, you guys. I think it will be really, really nice. I kind of have met most of you a little bit. Actually, Tim, we were like one of the only people that haven't really met online before, outside of email or something like that. So would love you to share something about yourself in an email. Love to know. Yeah. Okay, so right now we have 10 people that applied. We still have 4 spaces left for the camp. So if you want to join right now, then definitely still join as soon as you can. And after you apply, so now you have applied, and after that, I will be sending you an email with all the information, the link where you can join and pay for the camp. So if you want to join, you have to pay without in a certain amount of time to make sure that also other people that might want to reply for the early bird prize can still make it. So yeah, I assume that everybody that is applying is just going to do that. But I just want to be sure that after that, you have to make a timely payment. Otherwise, your place will go to the next person. So I will share with you in the email, especially. Okay, so everybody that is not in the camp and not in the academy needs to get a free academy account. That's what Kalin says, so we can get to know them. Yeah, it would be nice to, like, I feel like many actually are in the academy that have joined, but some are not. So definitely, guys, be sure to join the academy because we chat there almost every week, like 4 times a week or something like that. We are meeting each other to jam together, to have lessons together, and then we are always communicating in the Facebook group. So if you already want to meet some of your fellow camp attendees, this would be a great place to connect before the camp starts already. So joining the academy is just right now just $35, $39 a month. So it's a great value for like many, many weekly lessons and workshops. And there are so many things you can do in the academy. I won't share about it right now, but there you can meet some of the fellow people. Yeah, I feel like everybody is saying, like, I talk to everyone every day in the academy, lol. That is how I feel too, because we have so many meetups that I feel like I'm talking more with the people from the academy than my family and friends. So it's like a really nice family, extra family to have. So somebody else said, I applied. Did you get it? So maybe I have to refresh the page. Right now I'm refreshing the page. Oh my God, there's 13 responses. Kalin, you need to apply now because I want to be fair, but I know you wanted to join. So really would love you to apply because I know you wanted to join from the beginning and you were one of those that have been motivating me to do the camp. So the next person that applied just came in, Mariana, indeed. That's amazing. She is a beginner and has been playing for 1 year. And yeah, so exciting. Where are you from, Mariana? Yeah, you will get a confirmation very soon with all the information. And maybe I will be sending them out tonight, if that's possible. I'm just looking at Sasha, the tech guy that is helping behind the scenes. Sasha, is it possible that they get a confirmation tonight that we will send them, or maybe tomorrow?
Yeah, I would say tomorrow.
Yeah, tomorrow you will get a confirmation with all the data. Like tomorrow you can make the payment. I think you will get maybe, I'm not sure about the time. We didn't set a limit. I think 24 hours, something like that. You can choose if you want to pay in 1 installment or 3. And Mariana is sharing she is coming from Cyprus. Wow, that's amazing. That's a place where, yeah. Oh, there's somebody else that is sharing. Maybe you can get in with Ineke at Marleen. Marleen can maybe get in with Ineke. Ineke and Marleen, do you want to be together in one room? You can let me know by email, and I would love to place all of you together to rooms that fit. Now just opening, there's a few more appliances. Right now there's 13, so there's one spot left. And right now, Big Mama Violin is doing a shout out. I booked a double room with another woman like to share with me. Marleen says, yes, I would like to share. Or Ineke says, Marleen, I would like. Okay, please, because I get a little, I'm not sure who is saying what. So make sure to send me an email if you want to change anything about which room you booked or where you want, in which room you want to be in. And now the camp is officially fully booked, by the way. 14 people applied. Okay, I'm sharing the last people that applied right now. So right now the application time is over. The last people that applied were Peter Curry from Germany. Like, he's from England, but he lives in Germany right now. Then Linda and Rael. And I will open Linda and Rael right now to see who they are. Could you put Marleen with Martine? Yes, I will put Marleen and Martine in the same room. Would you? And I will change it to a two-bedroom. Ineke will be changed to a two-bedroom. Rael is from the UK, and she has been playing for 1 year too. And she's a vegetarian, just like me. That works well. Okay, I'm so excited to meet everybody. So thank you so much, Rael, for applying. I hope I pronounced your name correctly. And I'm really looking forward to meet you at the camp. I will be sending you an email tomorrow, and all the others too. Next person, the last person that applied is Linda. I think there's a lot of women that applied. Most of them are women, and maybe two men or three. And Linda, not sure where she's from, but she's also vegetarian. So nice, so many of you are vegetarian. I think I read in about four applications that you guys are vegetarian too, so that actually makes half of the camp vegetarian, including me and the other organizer, who's also vegetarian. So so it will be a vegetarian camp, you guys. So if you don't want to eat healthy, be prepared. Be prepared to take your own snacks. So, yeah. Okay, so that were all the people that applied. Wow, that is amazing. I'm so happy to see all of you join our camp. It is really great. I'm so happy to see so many names that I know, because I really look forward to meet you. And I also look forward to meet everybody that I don't know yet, because, yeah, I'm so excited. I feel like it's going to be a really nice group with so many adult beginners that have been playing for a year or something like that. I think that's so much fun to be able to play together very soon and, you know, to inspire each other to practice. And sometimes we adults, we are a little bit afraid if we learn something new to put ourselves out there and play with others. You're often like, oh, just doing private lessons or something like that. But I think it's so important to really start experiencing music, to put yourself out there and to play with others and to have experiences, because this is why we learn the violin. We don't learn the violin to only practice in our practice room every day for over an hour or something like that. We learn the violin to enjoy ourselves. So this is exactly what we will be doing in this week. We will not only learn, but also have fun and play together and have a great time. So yeah, I'm so excited to be meeting everybody very, very soon. So right now the application, there is 14 applications, but if you still want to apply, you will get on the waiting list. And if there's any spot coming free, I will let you know. So if you still want to join and are like, oh gosh, I'm just 1 second too late, let me know. And as soon as somebody won't says I don't want to join anymore, or whatever comes in their way, which I hope that for nobody of you, of course, will happen, but it can happen sometimes, then you will be the first one that I will contact. So really be sure to still join on the moment that, on the moment that you are unsure. So, yeah. Let's see, go back to... Yeah, so make sure to join anyway. And Linda says, hi, I'm Linda from Germany, from Heidelberg. That's so nice. There's many Germans in the camp. I feel like Anya's from Germany. I live in Germany, so I speak German too. And I've heard that many people want to learn German at the camp. But don't worry, if you're from England and don't want to learn German, we are going to speak English during camp. But maybe there will be a German talking group at some point. And then we will just play the violin. So, yeah, there's now 15 responses. So I'm really happy to just keep responding and applying. So you will be, I will just really go like first person first and the second person. So if you are the 15th, you will be the first one that will get a place. So I can have a look who is the 15th person right now. And that will be the person that gets a spot if anybody decides not to join in the end, or if anybody, something comes in their way of joining. Yeah. Oh, okay. So Marlene says, I meant a room for Anya. Did you tell about the dates? Yeah, it will be the 29th about until August 3. So you can find all the details on the website. And Kalin is going to get the first place if anybody is not joining. There's a lot of people to send emails, so I think I will sign off now. Thank you so much for joining this live event revelation. So yeah, I'm so excited to see you apply, and yeah, I really, really look forward to our camp. I think we are going to have a great time together. So yeah, I'm already excited. So see you everybody, goodbye. And please send me all your specific things by email, julia@violinspiration.com, if you want to change your room. Right now I understood that Ineke wants to be placed. No, yeah, Ineke will be together with Martina, right, from Canada. So just to be sure, is that true, if they are still there? Yeah. So make, you know, Ineke, and if you are still there, like, definitely send me an email and share exactly with who you want to be in the room and how you want me to arrange it, because I'm going to do so as to the best of my ability. So thank you so much, everybody, for applying, and make sure to contact each other. You know, I'm going to put you guys in contact if anybody's not there in the chat anymore. I will still keep it in mind that Ineke and Martina and Marlene would like to be with other women in the room, and maybe I will make it happen. And if not, I will send you an email and ask you what to do about it, or maybe if we have to change the room or something like that. Yeah. And Ineke also wants to be placed with Marlene. So yeah, I will send an email about it. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining. And see you very soon, everybody that is in Julia's Violin Academy. I will see you tomorrow for our next live lesson. I think it will be 7. So be sure to be there at 7 if you want to join. I'm not sure yet what we will do. I will right now put a poll in our Facebook group and see what you guys want to learn about, and you can vote. So yeah, see you tomorrow, everybody. Goodbye.